Ladies and gentlemen, members of the TEDx Wheelock Street Selection Committee, faculty, staff, and students of Tufts Dartmouth Business School, family and friends, and fellow Toastmasters. The title of my speech today is always put the socks back on, and other important life lessons from a doctor. I've been a doctor for over 30 years. Wow, that makes me really old.
That's right.
In that time, I've treated thousands of patients. I've seen some miraculous cures, some heartbreaking failures. I've seen people at their best and at their worst. Throughout my career, I've learned many important life lessons that have made me a better doctor. But you don't have to be a doctor to benefit from the experiences I've had and the lessons I've learned. Today, I'm going to share with you three important life lessons from a doctor. Lesson number one, always put the socks back on. One day, I was called to the emergency room to see a patient. The patient was a cute little old lady with a beautiful crown of silver gray bushy hair and some spiffy socks. Just like mine, what a coincidence. She had passed out and fallen at home. Fortunately, she didn't break anything. I began to interview her. But she wasn't very talkative or responsive. Hello, anybody home? I came to the conclusion that she was demented and that I was not going to get much information out of her. I proceeded to examine her from head to toe. Toward the end of my exam, I took off her socks, to check her feet for swelling. No swelling here. Seeing no swelling, I stood up and turned to leave the room. Before I can get one step away, I hear this high-pitched, screechy voice behind me saying, "Doctor, where are you going?" I turn around to see my cute little old lady staring me in the eyes. "Well," I said, "I finished your exam. Now I'm going to see another patient." "But doctor," she continued, "you took my socks off and you didn't put them back on." I was stunned by what she was saying because I really didn't think she had a clue about what was going on. She then says, "You men, you're always taking our clothes off, but you never put them back on." That is the truth, is it, ladies? I see some ladies shaking their heads. Well, what are the lessons that I learned from this encounter? First of all, I learned that you should always finish what you start. Always finish the job. Don't be sloppy, and don't try to cut corners. thing I learned was that you should never assume that someone doesn't see or understand what you're doing with them. When you assume, you make an ass of you and me. Don't be an ass, like I was. Always put the socks back on. Lesson number two, speaking of assumptions, you should never assume that the information you are given or the results of a medical test are always correct. On a day, about 20 years ago, I had my first personal experience with a serious illness. Up until that day, I had never been sick a day in my life. On that day, I was walking through the hospital when suddenly I began to feel extremely tired. I just thought I hadn't got enough sleep the night before. As the week dragged on, I felt progressively fatigued, and then I started feeling a sharp pain in my chest. The pain got worse whenever I took a deep breath. I went to my doctor, who examined me. She didn't find anything wrong with me. She thought I probably just had the flu, but just to make sure, she sent me for a chest x-ray. I went for the x-ray and then called my doctor later for the results. She tells me that the report of the x-ray says that my chest is completely normal. I was feeling so bad that I found it hard to believe that my x-ray could be normal. To confirm my suspicions, I went down to the radiology department to look at the x-ray myself. When I looked at the x-ray, I was shocked at what I saw. My lungs looked fine, but my heart had this strange, unusual shape to it. I rushed down to the heart lab to get an ultrasound scan of my heart, which I did myself. You want something done right, you gotta do it yourself. Whoa! The scan showed that my heart was surrounded by fluid, enough fluid to fill a large bottle of Coca-Cola. I had made my own diagnosis. I had pericarditis, a viral infection of a sac that surrounds the heart. I had caught it from a patient I had seen a few weeks before. Fortunately, I did need a drainage procedure, and I gradually improved over the next few weeks. What I learned from this experience was that we should not always accept what we see, hear, or read as being true without question. We need to use our own good judgment to analyze the information we're given before we accept it as fact. I also learned that we're all only human and that any of us, even doctors, can get sick at any time when we least expect it. Be sure you have good health insurance. Lesson number three. Are you ready for this? Uh-oh. Lesson number three is that stuff happens. Things happen that cannot be easily explained. Question. What are the two words that every doctor dreads hearing over the hospital loudspeaker system?
Stats.
Code blue emergency room. Code blue emergency room. I was a young resident doctor on call for the hospital emergency response team. I rushed down to the emergency room to find an elderly man who was in full-blown, code blue cardiac arrest. Quick, insert the intravenous tube. You, start chest compressions. You, insert the breathing tube into his lungs. Everyone was doing their part to save this man's life. We brought in the defibrillator machine. The shockers hopped back in the rhythm. Everyone, clear the bed. Shocking, 200 joules. Shocking, 300 joules. Nothing was working. We continued our resuscitation attempts for over an hour. The EKG remained flatline. He had no pulse. He wasn't breathing on his own. We finally came to the conclusion that our efforts were futile. Let's call it, we all agreed, time of death, 7:25 p.m. We left the room to speak to the family and to let the nurses prepare the body for transfer to the morgue. I was just about to speak to the family when suddenly one of the nurses in the patient's room started screaming. He's still breathing. We rushed back into the room, and to my astonishment, he was breathing. I felt his neck. He had a pulse. We hooked up the EKG machine. He had a heart rhythm where he had been flatlined for the last hour. Oh. We resumed our resuscitation efforts. We were able to stabilize him and transfer him to the intensive care unit. Over the next few weeks, he gradually improved, woke up, and eventually left the hospital. Oh. To this day, I cannot come up with a medical or scientific explanation as to how this man came back to life. Somewhat was certain death. His dramatic, improbable recovery was a true medical miracle. How many times have we heard of things happening that could not be easily explained? How many times have we heard of people surviving against impossible odds? The explanation? Stuff happens. Miracles do happen. In conclusion, I've talked about three important life lessons from my career that we can all benefit from. Lesson number one. Always put the socks back on. Always finish what you start to the best of your ability. And don't be a, you know what? Ass. That's right, I said it. Lesson number two. Never assume any of the information you're given is always correct. Use your own good judgment to analyze the information you're given before you accept it as fact. As a patient, you need to be your own healthcare advocate. If a medical test or diagnosis doesn't explain all your system, you have to question it. And please be sure you have health insurance. Mm-hmm. We're all only human, even us doctors. And finally, believe it or not, stuff happens. Miracles do happen. The author, Mary Oliver, gave us some good advice as to what to do when we encounter important life lessons. Pay attention. Be astonished and tell them. Thank you, Toastmasters.